Hey, this is Mithun from Team Digit, and this is Zotac's GeForce GTX 980. It happens to be the Amp Extreme Edition. Earlier, Zotac had just the Amp Edition, which was a factory overclocked card, but now they have bifurcated, or rather broken it down into four SKUs. You have the base edition, just the Amp Edition, the Amp Omega Edition, the Amp Extreme Edition. With each increment, you have an increment in factory overclock as well. This one in particular is overclocked by 165 megahertz, which makes it 1291 overall, and that's a very impressive overclock. So let's take a look at the box. First, we have mentioned that it's a 4GB SKU, which is standard. Then they have something called OC Plus, which allows you to monitor the overclock, and it basically gives you all card details or health settings, whatever you call it. Then you have what's called Ice Storm. That's what Zotac calls its cooling mechanism, which includes the fins, the fans, the heat pipes, and the whole works. And lastly, you have Light.Id, which is something that we've seen with other manufacturers. What it does is, depending upon the GPU utilization, you have the lights turning into a different shade. So green would mean it's under light load, and as it turns towards red, it means the load is increasing. You can switch it off, but let's flip the box around and see what else is new. So here we see it's a three fan setup, and then we have a little demonstration of the Light.Id. It's either red or green, and the rest seems to be pretty much the usual fare. So let's open the box up and check it out. So let's take it out of the box. So this has a very nice leathery finish. It looks like snakeskin, but I doubt Zotac harms snakes. And you have a magnetic cover. So first off, we get to see a little pouch with a few documentation. This is about boost, then there's the warranty, and then the manual. We also have the driver disk, if you want to see that. Here we have a VGA to DVI adapter. There's nothing underneath that. And we have one dual 6-pin to 8-pin adapter. Another one of that. Last one seems to be some sort of micro USB to USB connector. We'll go through that later. Do check the review for this. And let's get to the card. So it's quite a beefy look. They call this thing the Exo Armor. And it has 390mm fans. And this is where you'll see the Light.Id LEDs change their colors according to the load. It has a backplate the same way it was there in the reference card, but obviously since the PCB is slightly different in this one, it has been customized for that. You have the OC Plus logo over here, and we are yet to see the here's a connector for that USB micro thing that we saw earlier. And it's a bit tight. So we have three display ports and one HDMI and one dual link DVI as well. On the top you have the Sli Bridge Connectors. I don't know if you can see this properly, but there are multiple layers to this whole Exo Armor thing. You can see one heatsink, you can barely see it over here. That's sitting on top of the VRM, and beneath that you get to see the fins, and after that comes the heat pipes and all of that. It uses two 8-pin power connectors, but considering that the 980 is much more power efficient, it's a security measure more than a necessity. That's it for this unboxing. Do check the review to know how good this card performs in comparison to the reference.